There's this major question that many people have always asked themselves, and there's actually a subscriber who asked me this question concerning Jonah. And today I'm going to be speaking about the question. This question: did Jonah die when he was in the belly of the fish? Did Jonah die when he was in the belly of the fish? Now, it's very good to understand that those who accept the literal, those who accept the literal account of Jonah, they take one of the two main views regarding what happened to Jonah during his time in the belly of the great fish. One of those two views, I'm going to give you the two views, but let me start with the first one. One of those two views the holds that Jonah died and later returned to life. That's what they say. And the second view holds that Jonah remained alive for 3 days in the belly of the great fish. And both views agree on a literal reading of the book of Jonah, and they do affirm God's supernatural ability to rescue his prophet. The difference is whether to see Jonah 2:10 as a description of a weak and a bedraggled Jonah, or as truly resurrected Jonah. Now let's first go and see John 2:10. Jonah 2:10. What does it say? It says, "And the Lord spake unto the fish, and it vomited out Jonah upon the dry land." Okay. Now, let's first and foremost start with those who argue that Jonah died and later rose again. Okay? Appealing to Jonah's prayer in Jonah 2:2. Okay? Jonah 2:2. Let me just come here and show you. "And said, I cried for reason of mine affliction unto the Lord, and he heard me out of the belly of hell." So people look at this word, hell, and they're like, he must have died. "Cried I, and thou hearest my voice, heardest my voice. Now, from the depths of the grave, I called for help." Now, the use of a Sheol, the Hebrew term for the grave, could have meant that Jonah actually died. Yet the words, "the depths of the grave," seen as a poetic turn of phrase, could easily refer to an agonizing or horrifying experience. It was like it felt like death. That's one view. But also, there's another major reason that some people argue that Jonah literally died and resurrected. Because we see in Matthew 12 verse 40, it says, "For as Jonah was 3 days and 3 nights in the whale's belly, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and 3 nights in the heart of the earth." So the reasoning is that since Jesus's death and resurrection were actual, then Jonah must also have actually died and later returned to life, just the same way like Jesus. However, Jesus's comparison does not mandate perfect congruency between the two events. Jonah's hopeless situation, this kind of very hopeless situation, was an illustration of Jesus's death. Okay, that's we can agree. But Jonah's sudden appearance at Nineveh was an illustration of who? Do you get the point here? Was an illustration of Jesus' resurrection. The 3 days were an additional similarity. Jonah was 3 days, Jesus was 3 days. And the 3 days, they both represented each of them, Jonah and Jesus. And Jonah returned from the edge of of death, and Jesus, who is greater than Jonah, returned from the actual death. So analogies do not require absolute agreement in every detail. That one we can agree. So now we see that the Bible does not explicitly state that Jonah died in the belly of the great fish. Those who theorize it and that he died, they rely on inference and just speculation that, yeah, Jonah died. What is the evidence that Jonah stayed alive for 3 days? What was the evidence? And that he spent in the belly of the great fish. So the evidence is very clear that Jonah did not die. Let me show you the evidence. You see, the Bible tells us that Jonah prayed from inside the fish. Okay? Jonah 2 verse 1. Then Jonah prayed unto the Lord, his God, out of the fish belly. So that's an evidence of what? That Jonah was alive. Are you seeing the point here? Jonah was alive. At the very least, Jonah lived long enough to offer his prayer in the belly of the fish. And secondly, the language of Jonah's prayer is very poetic in nature. The kind of prayer that he was praying is very poetic in nature. Terms such as the Sheol, which means hell, and the reference to the pit. Look at that. They do not have to be interpreted so literally as to require physical death. Just look at Jonah 2:6. I went down to the bottoms of the mountains. The earth with her bars was about me forever. Yet hast thou brought up life from my corruption, O Lord my God. You see the similarity? But it means this guy was praying. He was praying. He was praying. And it means he had to have life so that he can be there and pray. So, did Jonah die in the fish? Or was he alive the whole time? Anyway, either of the two interpretations are possible, because it's something which have not been told clearly in the Bible, you cannot really say. But the traditional understanding that Jonah was alive for 3 days in the belly of a great fish is more likely. Because Jonah, who everyone thought was a goner, he already went, emerged. He just came out, poop, you know, all of a sudden. He emerged from the murky depths to bring God's message of salvation to a lost and dying people. In so doing, he became a wonderful representation of Jesus' death, burial, and resurrection, and giving the message of salvation. Are you seeing the point? Just the same way Jesus was in the belly. I mean, it was in the belly of the world, you know, down in the grave. And then he rose with a good message that, hey, I am alive now. Here's the message, the gospel, the good news that I'm alive. I think this was also a representation which was shown. Jonah was also a representation of the coming Jesus who would come and save mankind through the message of the cross. So this one and this one, they present almost the same thing. But we know Jesus is greater and his message was more powerful than the message of Jonah. And so forth. So anyway, do you believe the message of Jesus? Have you ever heard the message of Jesus? What's the message? For you to understand this message of Jesus, there are three things that you have to understand. I mean, five things. Number one, you have to understand the bad news first. What is the bad news? That you're a sinner and all sinners deserve to die. The wages of sin is death. You are a sinner from your father Adam. The Bible says in Genesis 5:3 that Adam lived some several years, and he lived a couple of years, and then he begat a son in his own image and in his own likeness and called him Seth. Now that image that we have is the image of Adam, the fallen state of man, and all the descendants of Adam had the same image, and that's the image we have, and the image of sin, and the wages of sin is death. That's the bad news you have to understand. And after you hear the bad news, you hear the good news. But one man called Jesus 2,000 years ago, while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. So that if we believe in him, we'll not perish, but will have everlasting life. We will have his life. So if you believe in him, you get the image of Christ. If you don't, you remain in the image of Adam, sinful. And number three is that you have to understand the gospel. You see, you can hear the gospel but don't understand. And if you don't understand, you cannot be saved. Understanding is a key fact. That's why the Pharisees, they had the law, but they had not understood it. That's why they even killed Jesus, because they could not understand. Because understanding is a key fact. We believe from our hearts, we don't believe from our minds. And number four, you believe. After you understand, you believe. You believe that totally Jesus did this for me. And number five, you confess what you have believed. Tell Jesus, "Jesus, I know you died for my sins, you were buried and rose again the third day according to the scriptures. I believe you, I trust you, be my Lord and my Savior. And for sure, you're saved, sealed, and sanctified unto the day of redemption." Hope this has been a blessing to you. Hope it has helped you to understand the comparison between Jesus and Jonah, and what does it mean. And for sure, did Jonah die in the belly of the fish? If you enjoy these videos, please give them a like, and also you can subscribe to watch more videos and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss any new video which you post. And likewise, at the description, we have a couple of other channels outside the YouTube. You can go and check them out and also share to your friends, and also this one. God bless you and have a good time.